1. Flavor text. You have been traveling a long time. So long that civilization, with its roads and commerce, is a strange pageant for you. You crest a hill, and as the dust from a merchant caravan settles before you, the vista opens over pastures and fields that push up in green splendor from the dry landscape around. At the edge of it, a ribbon of blue beckons you. Above, a cloud hangs over land, and you see a blurred curtain of moisture fall, the first rain you've seen in a month. Your mouths are dry, and your fingers cracked with dirt. The road you find yourself on winds through the farmland toward a port town. The sign reads, Ya Amon, population seasonal, and it looks like you're here in the high season. As you trudge down from the hills, you pass pilgrims and traders with carts of wares. You pass salty lugs with shifty steps and a band of refugees from some border squabble, their lives on their backs. The fields on either side are worked with a brisk efficiency, and it seems like you are tourists to the very model of progress. There is something strange about these farmers, though, and these farms. They work ceaselessly, and one's movements are the same as another's. Vast rows of people cutting the harvest in unison. Your companion curls his nose and says
that they don't smell like sweat.
But though the wind is blowing your way, it's too far to see exactly who or how they are. Just heavy pants and shirts and heads wrapped in cloth, a lot of garb for such a hot day. You push sweat back from your cheeks. The town gate approaches, a wooden stockade standing guard around it. Beyond the first gate, you see an older stone wall, and beyond that, the town meets the enormous river. The town opens in concentric circles to you, the widest circle being the newest construction. It looks like there's some toll to pass through the door. You don't have much coin between you. The refugees are turned away after offering a pouch twice as heavy as yours. They join others who have set up tents on either side of the road. An old man offers you a bowl of cold porridge. You may not make it into town today after all. Suddenly, the sound of horses tramping and rolling wheels clattering on the now stone-paved road drowns your perception, and you're nearly run down by a richly appointed carriage. It stops behind you, the purple curtains of a gold-trimmed window part. A sleek, gloved hand emerges and hooks a black leather finger, as a falconer may offer a perch. A small green bird flutters through the gate toward the carriage, skipping between the sharp pikes of the guards. Its flight will take it over your heads. You notice on the bird's leg a small scroll wound and tied. What do you do?